Electoral Commission is set out on set out in Section 5 of the Principal Act.
Madam Chair.
I call the Honourable Dr Nick Smith.
Madam Chair, the next amendment that this Parliament needs to consider relates to the important role that the Electoral Commission has. And what we propose to do with this amendment is to extend the functions of the Electoral Commission to include reporting on the use of the new vacancy provisions where a leader can sack a Member of Parliament. Now, I think this Parliament has a great deal of respect for the independence of the New Zealand Electoral Commission. They conduct our elections, and actually, Madam Chair, I'm very proud of the fact that in the last general election, we got one of the highest rankings in the world for the conduct of our elections and for the standing of our democracy. In fact, The Economist magazine last year ranked New Zealand the third best of 170 democracies in the world. Now, our concern is that this amendment and this bill is going to take us backwards. Why do we know that? Well, we know from reputable organisations like the International Parliamentary Union that these measures are described as political party dictatorships. In fact, the International Parliamentary Union goes even further. It says the free mandate of members of parliament is essential to any parliamentary democracy. So what we're saying with this amendment is that we need the Electoral Commission to independently report on the use of these new provisions. I am deeply worried that these amendments are going to be used, in the words of the government's own Attorney General, to chill the expression of views of dissenting members of parliament. That's what the government says the bill will do. And so I would say we need someone, somewhere, to act as a check on this extraordinary power that is being created. And we think the appropriate check should be a new requirement in Section 5G for the Electoral Commission to have to consider and to report to this House on those new measures that allow a party leader to dismiss a Member of Parliament. What sorts of things would I expect to be covered in those reports? Well, I'd expect the Electoral Commission to look at whether there was fair process, because there's very widespread concern, Madam Chair, about the processes in this bill. The fact that it breaches the Bill of Rights in the views of 21 constitutional lawyers. The fact that there is very little definition, as we've debated, around the issue of what constitutes acting in such a way that a leader of a party is entitled to dismiss you. It would enable the Electoral Commission to report on the issue of the by-election, because where a Member of Parliament is dismissed, the Electoral Commission will then have the responsibility for organising the by-election in that particular area. And can I tell you where there's a real question and why the Electoral Commission does need to report? It is this. Anybody that's been involved in a by-election, you know what the public asks first? Why are we having a by-election? They do. They're surprised. And they will be surprised when they find that their democratically elected Member of Parliament has been dismissed.
Can I just
and the Electoral Commission
remind the member that this proposed amendment will not have anything to do with the conduction of by-elections?
Madam Chair,
I know that the member is making...
Well, Madam Chair, what this provision does is it requires the Electoral Commission to report to the House on any use of vacancy provisions that are created under Section 55 and 55AAB. And let's be honest about what happens in 55A. An MP gets dismissed and there's a by-election. And so in my view, it is entirely appropriate. What's more than that is this. If the member is a list member, it is the Electoral Commission that has the responsibility for approaching who is the next Member of Parliament on the list and then being returned as the new compliant Member of Parliament, having been able to get rid of a dissenting one. Now, my view is it is entirely appropriate that this Parliament requires the Electoral Commission to regularly report to Parliament. I put to the House There is a long list of matters and functions of the Electoral Commission. A, B, C, D, E, F, and now G.
I call the Honourable Gerry Brownlee.
Madam Chair, I rise to support the amendment that's